We're going to take a look at the last step, which is solving for the variable, the easiest one of them all. All right, so the fifth step, solving for the variable, and you're just going to put the fraction bar in one on, and a one underneath the one without, cross multiply and divide, or you're going to take the inverse, whichever one we have. So let's look at the previous page and see what we had, then write it out. So we had 10 over 42 equals x over 40. All right, so which one is this? Put a fraction bar under the 1 without. So 1042 doesn't have a fraction. So put a 1 underneath, cross multiply and divide. So it's going to be 40. Now put the 40 in front. 40 times 1042 equals x. And all you do is punch it in the calculator. And we just did this in the previous step. So you're going to do 40 times 10. So hit the 10 button. And then 40. And then press enter. So 36.01, and then the question said round to nearest tenth, so it's going to be 36.0. This is a listening check, coloring 36 feet, right? Let's take a look at the second one, write it out. So sine 8 equals 1000 over x. So again, the only two types of questions you're going to have, either you're finding the inverse or put in a fraction, so it's put in a fraction, cross multiply and divide. It's going to be x sine b or equals 1000, divide both sides by sine b because we're going to try to get x by itself. So we're going to get x equals, and you're going to put that in the calculator. 1,000 divided by 1,000 divided by sine, and then 8. I don't know why I said b. My bad. Sine 8. Can't read my own handwriting. I just realized my calculator is in the wrong degree, so I'm going to go and change it because that number was weird. And then do it again. So that's the problem. You know, when the calculator is in the wrong mode, you get a wrong answer. So I've just changed it back, and we need to round this to the nearest tenth as well. So means one number after the decimal place, and then you look at the number next to it. Is a 9 going to make that 2 go up or stay the same? It makes it go up because it's bigger than 5. It's 5 and bigger. All right, make sure you put the units feet. All right, example 3, so two pages over, copy it down, which is cosine of x equals 3 over 20. All right, this one is not a fraction because we need to get isolate x by itself. We need to take the inverse because remember, if it's cosine of something, to get rid of it, you take the inverse, like we did here. So it was sine c equals something, and that's what we have. So you take the inverse. So x equals the inverse of cosine 3 over 20, and that's what you do. So you go second on cosine, so that's going to give you the inverse, and 3 over 20, just like we practiced in the previous video. I believe this is also the nearest 10, so at 7 is going to make that 3 go up 1, so it's 81.4 degrees. I'm just going to double check the units. Don't forget to write down the units of feet and degrees. All right, example 4, write it down. So two pages over, write it down. 1070 equals 500 over x. X, we're not looking for the angle, so we're going to put a fraction. Cross multiply and divide. So that's going to be x, 1070 equals 500 times 1, which is 500. And then divide. How do you get x by itself? Divide by 1070. So divide both sides by 1070. It's a listening check. Put a box around the answer for example 3 and color it in. And you're going to punch that in the calculator. So 500 divided by 10. So you're going to hit 10 and then 70. Press enter. And we are rounding this to the nearest. I got to go look at the question. Nearest foot. Example 4, nearest foot. So there should be no numbers after the decimal. That rounds to 182. All right, number 5. Copy it down. Cosine of 8 equals x over 2000. We're not looking for an angle, so this one you're going to put a 1 underneath the one without. And cross multiply and divide. So you're going to get 2000 times cosine 8 equals 1 times x, which is x. And then you can put that in the calculator because you just got x by itself. So 2000 times cosine 8. And we're rounding to the nearest. This is a listening check. Color in the zeros in the number 2000 foot. All right, so no decimals. That 5 is going to change at 0 to a 1 because 5 and above changes it up 1. Anything below keeps it the same. All right, last one. Cosine of 38 equals 30 over x. Put a 1 underneath, cross multiply and divide. So you're going to get x cosine 38 times equals 30. And then divide both sides by cosine 38 to get x by itself, and then put in the calculator, 30 divided by cosine of 38. And this one is to the nearest meter, so there should be no numbers. That zero is going to keep it the same, so 38. And that's it. Let's practice.